All right, I'm Dr. Paul. Let's go over how to determine your chiropractic office geographic radius of draw and psychographic boundaries. And these are the reasons I'm going to share with you why this is important. There's really seven chiropractor marketing mistakes that are big mistakes. Number one is naming their business wrong. Number two is placing their business in the wrong demographic location. Number three is market for non-gateway conditions. Number four is marketing using no motivation messages. And number five is market outside their geographic radius of draw and psychographic barriers. So that's what this topic is. And number six is marketing to cold call prospects. And number seven is marketing using words and concepts that potential patients do not understand or even buy. So it is one of the common big mistakes in a chiropractic office. And so here are the five reasons why knowing your geographic radius of draw and not guessing and its psychographic boundaries are vital to marketing. First, it shows where to market to increase the effectiveness and where not to market to stop wasting time and money. Two is it'll reveal your location keywords, which is a must for marketing because 75% of the new patients pick chiropractors based on location. Now, it will also show your psychographic barriers. Now, psychographic barriers are areas where people will not travel that you may not have considered. Now, you must know your northern, southern, eastern, and western boundaries, and they will never be the same. It will never be a concentric circle. And typically what stops it is a psychographic boundary, mostly, and every now and then it's distance, but mostly psychographics. And it's important because it's based on reality of your marketplace, not your opinion. And the reason I say that is almost every chiropractor I consult with thinks their radius of draw is unbelievably larger than the reality of what it is. So these are the top five categories of why patients pick chiropractic services. And by the way, these are the five categories why we buy all products and services, but depending on the product or service, this may not be the order. Now, this is the order for chiropractic services. Now, number one is a trusted source. So when people buy products and services, the first place, and that's true for every industry, it's always number one in every industry, and it's because security is the second highest need in life. Now, after that, the number one reason, which is number two, is location. So 75% of your potential patients will pick your office because of the location. Is the office close? And price is only 15 to 20%. And the number one question there is, do you accept their insurance? And service is only 3%. And an example of service is if you are open on Saturdays or you stay late or something like that. And quality is only 3% of why people will pick a chiropractor. An example of that is higher degrees, certifications, or treatment techniques. So that kind of gives you an example. Now, obviously, it's not absolutely black and white, but there's what's called probabilities and possibilities, and these are location is the very high probability. And an example might be that the price might be good, maybe a doctor accepts your insurance or something like that. Maybe now he's 100 miles away. So you see how price now will become irrelevant relative to distance and location. And by the way, when we say location, that's what we're talking about is distance. So that's a classic example. And so one of the questions is how much sense does it make to target only 3% of a market and only 8% of that market are searching? So there's only 8% of the population looking for chiropractors. So how smart would it be if these are the five reasons why people are picking a chiropractor, that you're already starting with 8% and now you decide to promote a service or a quality component, which is only 3%. So now you're talking about 3% of 8%, so now a real small number, and you're limited by the geographic radius of draw, and you're surrounded by competition, the other chiropractors. And so the question is how much smaller do you want to go after business? I mean, you can just, the further you go off track here, you're already starting with a very low number, 8%. So, I wouldn't want to go less than that. I wouldn't want to do anything in my marketing to go less than that, because that's definitely a small number. And that's people who are looking for chiropractors. Now, these are some important factors that I talked about. There's only 8% utilization a year. There's only 8% of the population looking for chiropractors a year. So this is why you got to even pay way more attention to this, because this is 8% is not abundance. There's good news and bad news about that, though. Now, you are limited by distance. The location is the largest category at 75%. And then you're surrounded by the competition. And so you should focus on the 80% rule and not the minority or 20%. So it's back to the 80-20 principle. You'll get the best bang for the buck focusing on the 80, the majority, not the minority. And then referrals will travel slightly farther, but not much further. So if it is a trusted source, they will travel a little further, but they're not gonna travel that much further. And then what you also want to do is totally leave out what are called the 3% outliers. And an example of that is almost every time I ask a chiropractor, what their draw is, they may say, 20 miles or 50 miles, or they'll say, I have a patient that came 100 miles. And we don't pay any attention to the 3% of the people that are ridiculously outside of the norm. And so that in no way would be part of your geographic radius of draw. Seven categories, so these are the seven categories of target marketing to basically increase the effectiveness of your marketing. So we're looking at the business name. That's the most important part of your marketing. The unique segment position, those are the five reasons why people pick after there's a need. Then there's demographics. Demographics decide who buys. Psychographics decide why they buy. And then there's what's called psychographic barriers. They're typically unconscious barriers. They're typically not conscious. And then there's what's called the vehicle of delivery, how you would communicate with that target market. And then there's what's called gateways. What's the main reasons that they would pick you versus odd reasons why they don't see any association or why they would not pick you. So this is what gives you what's called a target market. So you can see number four, number five right there is geographics. And that's the distance. And the distance does vary depending on a chiropractic office. All chiropractic offices are not the same. And so we look at the distance, and then we look at the psychographic barriers, number six there. What are the limitations? And like I said, most of your peripheral limitations will not be a distance factor. It'll be a psychographic barrier factor. Now, there's three types of marketing to attract these patients. So remember, publicity only attracts the 8% of the population searching for chiropractors. So publicity will not attract the 92% who are not looking. So in other words, if you did a publicity piece, then if people aren't looking for it, they don't care. It's just wasted time and money. Same with advertising. Advertising will only affect the 8% who are looking. It will have nothing to do with the 92%. And so that's what you use. You use basically publicity and advertising to attract the 8% and get more of them. Now, only educational sales will attract the 92% that are not looking. So advertising and publicity will not. And educational sales also, so even if you know it and you're effective at it, it will not attract the population outside your geographic radius of draw and your psychographic barrier. So even when you do educational sales, it has to be within your geographic radius of draw. That's how important this is. So some of the geographic marketing principles of why you'd want to do this is understand your marketing zone. Everything else is a waste of time and money. Understand your keywords for location-based marketing, and that is paramount, because that's 75% of the reason why people choose when they don't know you. Understand your office psychographic boundaries. These are very important factors in why you need, and those apply to every type of marketing you do. It doesn't matter what it is. Now, the top five patient psychographic barriers. So these are some real common reasons why people won't travel in particular directions outside of distance. So driving away from an economic hub, that always, and the real reason for that is they're used to driving into an economic hub, so there's high familiarity. And so it's much more difficult to pull somebody away. A simple example is if somebody drives 7 miles into the economic hub. Well, they do it twice in and out, so they do that often, so there's high familiarity. And they typically won't drive out of that economic hub. So it's going to be very difficult to pull that person even 1 or 2 miles going out because it violates, it's a subconscious violation of familiarity. They think it's a perception, and believe me, the perception to them is very real. They think it's way out there. You tell them it's, you know, 2 miles or a mile, they go, oh, way out there. And it has to do with unfamiliarity. That's why they think that way. You can't change that. Advertising will not change that. You'll go broke before you try to change that. Waterways, rivers, and lakes are also major psychographic barriers. And you see this a lot, that towns and cities are split by lakes and rivers and things like that. That's very common, that they won't cross over or very rarely cross over. County lines, and actually county lines and highways are psychographic barriers. Major interstate highways. So especially if you combine a county line with a major interstate highway, people see that's a perceived block. So large bridges and railroad tracks can be psychographic barriers. That's why you've heard the term on the other side of the tracks, because it is a divider. So those are psychological reasons. So you'd have to be really aware of that. Large land masses like a natural forest, golf courses, industrial parks, large cemeteries. These large land masses, they're perceived as also barriers. They're distance barriers, these land masses. So there's two personal injury attorney psychographic barriers. Number one is a county line. And the reason that's important is the attorneys basically do business out of that county. Every county has what's called a county seat, and that's where the courthouse is and all the legal transactions take place. And so the attorneys, that's why the attorneys are all down and have their offices in the county seat, not just spread out all over the county typically. They may have a satellite office and then something like that. Or if it's an attorney that's not dealing routinely with the courthouse. So county lines are very important for personal injury marketing. It's very difficult. It's going to be much more difficult if you're on one side of the county line and now you're trying to market to attorneys on a different county line that use regularly and their offices are down at that county hub. So that, you know, there's other factors, but that's a big factor. You want to do what you can not to do that. So you want to market to the attorneys who are within your county because of those psychographic barriers. And then also remember, for them to go to another county, you're dealing with different people. So now you're back to violating the laws of familiarity and security, which is the highest need in life. So they've got to, not only do they have to travel, they got to take time, they got to deal with people they're not used to dealing with. You know, it's like all of us would rather deal with things where we deal with routinely and that we know versus unfamiliar areas. So that's what's so important with your personal injury attorney marketing. Now, they'll also pay attention to the patient-based geographic radius of draw because the attorney knows and they learn real quick. If they're not taught, they learn real quick that patients will stop going to a doctor. So if an attorney refers a particular patient to a doctor and it's a violation of the geographic radius of draw and psychographic barriers, that patient will miss their appointments and stop going. And real quickly, that attorney learns that doctor doesn't work that far away. So he kind of learns through market forces, geographic radius of draws. And so and that's very important because the number one factor that will limit that claim for the attorney and patient is missing their doctor's appointments. So this is very important. So we have to pay attention to these things because it would just be a total waste of time doing publicity, advertising, or educational sales to attorneys that are in total violation of geographic radiuses and psychographic barriers. So the office radius generalization. Now, this does not include psychographic barriers. So this is a very generalization. The inner city, and this is for a chiropractic office, a typical inner city, you'll get 80%, and it's the 80% rule. Because remember, that's what you want to do. You want to spend your time and money where you get the highest bang for the buck, the 80%, not the peripheral. So in the inner city, your radius of draw is typically 1 mile. And again, I'm not including psychographic barriers in this generalization. Now, the suburb is typically 3 miles. It's usually 2.5 up to 3. And county, it's 7 miles. So somebody in the inner city will not drive 7 miles to a chiropractor. And so you see, even chiropractic offices, based on where they're located, will have different geographic radiuses of draw. Now, none of those will be concentric radius of draws because of the psychographic barriers. So it doesn't matter if you're in a suburb, county, or city. You cannot look at that and just say, oh, I'm 3 miles. That's not going to be, you know, very accurate for all directions, north, south, east, and west. And it's a very simple reason why. Patients must get through obstacles. So they got to travel distances. They got to go through red lights. They got to go traffic. It's got to take time. So the more of these obstacles, these become barriers. And you start adding, you know, 10 little barriers. Well, now you gets to be a one big large barrier. That's how quickly this stuff adds up. So these are the steps to determine your geographic radius of draw and psychographic barriers. So number one, you just start with a county map, like one of those paper maps of the county. Now, if your office is near the county line, or right on the county line, then use both county. Use the adjacent county also and put it right next to it. And then you can get your map at a local gas station or a local AAA automobile association, and then place the map on the wall. And by the way, your staff should be doing this. The doctor, your staff should be reading this and should be watching this video for instructions on how to do this. So then you mark your office location on the map, and then you want to place the last 50 new patients. I mean, you just go straight back on your calendar, your last 50 new patients. Those are the patients that you want to put on that map, and you put their home addresses. That's what you put, their home addresses. And you mark where their home address is. Now, you want a minimum of 30. We want 50 to get enough data to have good information, but you don't want to do it under 30. So you can do it with 30, but we want 50, and that's good enough. And then also do not cherry pick. You will not have true statistics. So take your, you know, from your last new patient, going straight back, and put them on the map. And then you want to color code to patients, and just make the green for PI patients. If it's a personal injury patient, just make it green. If it's a blue, then if it's a referral, make it blue. And if it's a referred PI patient, then make it green and blue. So now it's green PI and blue referral. So blue or referral patients, and then any other category, just make them red, any other category. So you're just going to have basically three colors on the map. Now, this is how to interpret your geographic radius of draw and psychographic barriers. And we want to apply the 80-20 principle. So we're going to pay attention to the high effective 80%, and we're going to throw away the peripheral 20%, because that accentuates and magnifies the effectiveness. So starting with your office, draw a line around the 80% cluster of patients in each direction from the north, south, east, or west. So if you look to the north, you're going to see where it kind of starts fading. The dots start fading. And so you want to just come in. Don't go to the outside of those dots. So go to those dots and then come in 20%. So you're going to have a few stragglers typically out there, and then just come in a little bit, and then that's where you would draw your line. And that's how you would do it in each direction, from the north, the south, east, and the west. And they all will be different. And then leave out the outer 20%, like I said. Do not include the 3% outliers. And that's what I was talking about. You know, somebody's uncle came in, you know, from 100 miles away or something like that. That is not how to run a business. So we're sticking with high effective systems is what we're doing, not peripheral incidental things. So you should see psychographic boundaries on those lines in each direction. So after you did this, you should kind of look at that map now, and you're going to kind of see one of those psychographic barriers. You're going to see a major interstate, county lines. You're going to see roadways, waterways, large land masses. That's typically what you're going to see easily 3 out of 4 times. Unless you're out in the country, then mostly it'll be a distance factor. But if you're in the suburb or inner city, it's going to be a psychographic barrier, not a distance factor that limits it. So if there are no psychographic barriers, then the distance will be the reason patients will eventually drop off. So you should see your 80% radius of draw and distance in each direction. And that'll tell you what your marketing is, your distance of marketing from the north, south, east, or west. And anytime you do any marketing, that is always the only place you go. So you should see the psychographic boundaries also. These will bring them out. Spend 80% of your time and money where 80% of your patients come from. So that's where you want to spend your time and money. Eliminate it. Just take out that extra 20%, that peripheral distance. Just take that out. Now, these are your geographic radius of draw, radius of marketing boundaries. So marketing outside these boundaries, and you are wasting your time and money. Even if they have high need, they'll just look in the book or get a referral for somebody who's in their backyard. That's what will happen. So the top 3 reasons chiropractors market outside their geographic radius of draw, and this is a very common problem. Chiropractors are always chasing outside of their target market. And I found there's 3 reasons. Number one is they do not know effective advertising principles and how to attract more of the 8% of the new patients who are looking. So that's basically a lack of marketing knowledge with the advertising. And remember, there's only 8% of the population that's confined into that geographic distance, and it's divided by the other chiropractors. Well, that leaves a low number of new patients. So if you're confined by a geographic radius of draw, and you are if you have a brick and mortar business, and then you don't know advertising very well, so you're getting even you're not even getting an average share of new patients relative to the chiropractors here. So now it's below average. You're confined by your limits, and let's say you have low bad marketing for the 8%, and now you have all the other chiropractors. Well, that is a classic formula for low new patients right there. And then the second reason is they do not understand geographic radius of draw and psychographic barriers. And low new patients force the chiropractors to go further because they think it's always better on the other side of the fence. And so when they don't get the business in their backyard because they don't have the knowledge and skill in advertising or educational sales, then they think it's always better somewhere else. And this happens all the time. And that's probably 95% of the chiropractors right there. And so, and the bad news is those people will have many resistances to coming to your office. And then the third reason is chiropractors do not have the knowledge of educational sales, educational sales will only attract the 92% in their office radius who are not looking. And so that's where the business is doing a little better with your advertising. Well, that'll get more patients of the 8%. But remember, 92% of those people, out of 92% of the population in your geographic radius of draw, 75% of them, 3 out of 4, have a chiropractic problem, back pain, neck pain, arthritis. They're not looking for the chiropractor. They're going to the doctor. They're taking medication. They're doing everything else but going to the chiropractor. Now, that's why publicity and advertising will not work. But educational sales is the only way to get that segment of the population, because advertising and publicity does not work because they're not looking. So you have to use educational sales. So the key to really doing very well is having better advertising, in other words, no advertising, to attract more of the 8%. But that's still not going to, that's not abundance. 8% is just not a big number. The real big number is the 75 of the 92%. And that actually represents 68% of the population. So it's 68% versus 8%. That's the difference it makes when you know educational sales versus advertising. And that's where the business is at. And by the way, that's how I opened 77 offices in 20 states, seeing over 40,000 new patients a year. So low new patients will typically result in two excuses. And so when chiropractors don't know advertising and they don't know educational sales, they're stuck with what's called market forces, low number of new patients. And then so do they understand that they don't know advertising and they're not good at it and they don't know educational sales or marketing? No, they don't know that. They're in a state of unconscious incompetence. They don't even know what they don't know. By the way, that's the worst state to be in, because then you can't even act. You don't even know what to do. And so the two most common excuses chiropractors typically make right now is my area is not health-minded, and the insurance in my area is bad. I can't tell you how many times I've heard chiropractors tell me that. And of course, it's always the chiropractors who don't know marketing. Because you're getting market forces. You're getting a low number of new patients because of what we just described. And typically, they don't even know how to educate them or talk to them very well. And so the patients stay just until they feel a little better. You know, 4-6 visits, no more than 8 visits, and they're gone. And so you have a really bad problem. And that I just described the vast majority of chiropractors. So that's how that's the importance of understanding what is called how to do your geographic radius of draw. And again, how important is this? Well, remember, right there, top 7 chiropractor marketing mistakes. Number 5, marketing outside your geographic radius of draw and psychographic boundaries. And remember, it's the number 2 reason people will pick a chiropractor after trust. This is very important.